My name is Chibwe, and I have a secret. I have a son, and he has cerebral palsy and autism. I never told him earlier because sometimes they're not sure of how people respond to such kind of information. But I believe this is the right time to do so.
Living with a child with autism in Zambia is very hard, because you know when you pass with a child, you know that people are talking about you behind you, just from the stares and the silence that you get. We have intentionally, with the mother, moved with him in public. I would carry him on my shoulders, walk around, to let it sink into people that we are proud of the boy. You know, there's something I wanted to tell you that I've not told you, of which it has really been a source of guilt for me, that I've kept this from you, who's somebody I would call a friend, a brother, a companion, and an advisor. I don't tell you that I have a son. He's now 7 years old, and he's autism. Or should I say, he has cerebral palsy. Sorry, I never told you earlier on. You know, sometimes when you have a burden, you find it very hard to take it out. Mm.
It's good that you've told me. We've been together for quite some time, and I've confided in you, and you've confided in me, and I've not met him. Mm. He's our son, yeah, regardless of the condition.
You know, there are all sorts of beliefs that maybe somebody sinned, or somebody was cursed, or somebody was bewitched, you know, such kind of things. And it becomes very hard to open up to people, especially family members.
I know it wasn't easy. It's not an easy thing to do, because we want to show that we
always perfect.
We are always perfect. But perfection is not in what we think is. Even in the condition the child is, there's perfection. So that is what we look for, and that is what we should always fight for, to ensure that the child gets the best of what we can offer.
Let me show you a picture of the boy.
He's a big man.
He's a big boy.
Thank you.
Yeah.
He looks like uncle. He's actually a gentle giant.
Yeah, handsome.
Sometimes I think he's too handsome to be my child. I'm happy that now he has a capable uncle to teach him all the good manners and the bad manners. Thank you very much, love.
Yeah!
He's tough.
He's after him, Dad.
Somebody I've known for a long time, I knew he'd take it positively. And whatever I have said, he didn't say it for sure. He really meant it. I know him. But now I feel relieved, I feel light, I feel confident. Going forward, I think I'm now able to walk forward with strength, encouragement, and knowing that I'm not walking alone.